हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ क्लास सिक्स इंग्लिश हनी सकल। दिस इज़ लेसन फाइव, अ डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ स्कूल एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर लेक्चर थ्री ऑफ द सेम लेसन। पॉइंट्स टू बी कवर्ड इन टुडेज क्लास। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, Introduction to the lesson will be given, then summary of the lesson will be told, thereafter discussion of book exercise will be done, then discussion of previous homework, and at last homework will be assigned on the basis of today's explanation. Introduction to the lesson. Now we'll begin with the school. What is actually a school? A school is a place where we not only get bookish knowledge but also the knowledge of our surrounding. We learn to be a good human being who is civilized enough to live in the society. Our teachers help us in our all-round development, which makes us a dutiful and a good person to serve the society. Now, I'm going to tell you the summary of the lesson, means what have we read so far in the lesson. First of all, the narrator had heard a great deal about the school. The school we are talking about in the lesson, the narrator had heard a lot about that school. Miss Beam, she was known for using simple teaching methods in a perfect way. She was the principal of the school and she used simple teaching methods in order to teach the students in such a perfect way that they could use those things in their daily lives. The boys and the girls were taught how to do things independently without any help. It means the students were taught to be independent in their lives. Interesting talks were held to raise their interest. Not only bookish knowledge was given in the school, but the topics of the students' interests were also raised so that students would be keen interested in their studies. The main objective, or we can say the main goal of the school, was to make the students more thoughtful and responsible citizens. So here we have come to know that what was the main goal of the school. The main goal of the school was to make the students more thoughtful and responsible citizens to live in the society. The narrator noticed a poor little girl being led by a boy as soon as he entered into the school. There was a girl of 12 or so, and she was being led by a boy who was 4 years younger to her, means he might be of 8 years old. Both of them were going through the garden and that little girl of 12 years was being led by a boy as soon as the author entered into the school. Later he saw a girl with crutches, means he could see a girl who could not walk and had crutches in her hands. The narrator got shocked and asked Miss Beam why was that so. He got shocked because as soon as he entered into the school, he could clearly see a blind girl, or a girl who had blindfold on her eyes. And later he could also see a girl with crutches, means the girl who could not walk. So He was eager to ask Miss Beam, who was the principal of the school, that why was that so? What was the reason behind that, behind the disabilities of those students? Miss Beam explained that the students had to play the role of blind, deaf, dumb, lame, and injured person once a semester. Miss Beam took the narrator to the girl who was playing the role of blind on that very day and left them alone to talk. Means Miss Beam took the narrator to the girl who was playing the role of blind on that very day so that the author could clear his doubts by talking with that girl, and Miss Beam left both of them alone to talk. The role the students had to play became a great learning for them. Why? Because the students could learn. They could feel that how the disabled person could feel or can feel in their lives. And the students could learn the real learnings of the lives. There were helpers also who had to help the other students. Means, if a person or if a student is playing the role of a blind person, then that very student will get the help of a helper for that very day so that that particular student can live perfectly. The narrator was talking to a blind girl and she explained everything to him. Everything means the feeling she could feel while having a blindfold on her eyes and everything that a blind person can feel. The girl shared that she felt scared of being hit at every moment, and this feeling was the most painful one. When the girl started sharing her feelings with the author, first of all, she shared that she felt scared. She felt afraid of being hit at every moment because she doesn't know what thing is kept in front of her and where is she going to put her next step. And that feeling was the most painful one for a blind person. After this experience, the narrator realized that he had also developed a concerned attitude towards the disabled, because a person who is able or who can do everything, for him or her, the life is smooth. But the person who is disabled, for example, blind, deaf, dumb, or any other disabled person, for that very person, the life becomes the most painful, the most worried. Now, we are going to discuss the previous homework, the homework which I assigned you in the previous class. Now, students, we shall begin with new words. Please write the name of the school before you begin and make correction work column at right hand side. Number one, peep means to look silently from the thin lines. Number two, misfortune means bad luck. Number three, misery means difficulty. Number four, awful means bad. Five, troublesome means difficulty. 6. Gradually means slowly. Each term, every child has one blind day, one lame day. Complete the line. Which day was the hardest? Why was it the hardest? Its answer: each term, every child has one blind day, one lame day, one deaf day. one injured day and one dumb day. Now here the second question comes, why was it the hardest? The dumb day was the hardest because the children's mouth could not be bandaged. So they really had to exercise their willpower to remain silent. It is generally seen that nobody can bandage the children's mouth. They cannot even stop speaking for few minutes until and unless they sleep. So this is the most difficult, or we can say the hardest thing for the children's mouth to bandage their mouths. What was the purpose of these special days? The purpose of these special days was to teach the children thoughtfulness, means how to be kind with others and how to be responsible citizens. So these days make the children appreciate and understand misfortune by making them share in the misfortune of others. So this was the purpose of these special days, that the students could learn that how do the other disabled persons feel when, if they are blind, deaf, dumb, injured, or if they are suffering with any other disability. And this thing teaches them kindness, means how to be kind with others and how to be responsible citizens in the society. Page number 62. Here we are going to begin with the book exercise working with text. A question: put these sentences from the story in the right order and write them out in a paragraph. Don't refer to the I shall be so glad when today is over. Having a leg tied up and hopping about on a crutch is almost one, I guess. I don't think I'll mind being deaf for a day, at least not much. But being blind is so frightening. Only you must tell me about things. Let's go for a little walk. The other bad days can't be half as bad as this. Now we are going to frame a story of the sentences which I just told you. Let's go for a little walk. Actually, that was the conversation between the author and the little girl when Miss Beam left them alone to talk with each other. So let's begin. Let's go for a little walk. Only you must tell me about things. I shall be so glad when today is over. The other bad days can't be half as this. Having a leg tied up and hopping about on a crutch is almost fun, I guess. I don't think I'll mind being deaf for a day, at least not much. But being blind is so frightening. Let me repeat it. Let's go for a little walk. Only you must tell me about things. I shall be so glad when today is over. The other bad days can't be half as this. Having a leg tied up and hopping about on a crutch is almost fun, I guess. I don't think I'll mind being deaf for a day. At least not much. But being blind is so frightening. Now, working with language, a question. Match the words and phrases with their meanings in the box below. Paragraph numbers are given just beside the words only. Number one word is homesick and its phrase, which is given in the lesson, is in third paragraph. Practically is in fourth paragraph. It pains me, seventh paragraph. Appreciate, ninth. Thoughtless, tenth paragraph. Exercise, 11th paragraph. Relief, 13th paragraph. Ghastly is in 14th paragraph. Now, I'll tell you the words with which you are supposed to match the words which were given there. Now, these are the options: almost, it hurts me, terrible, test the strength of, understanding the difficulties, wanting to be home, a welcome change, and the last one is not very caring. Now let's match those words. Answer: homesick means wanting to be home. Practically means almost. It pains me means it hurts me. Appreciate means understanding the difficulties. Thoughtless means not very caring. Exercise, test the strength of. Relief, a welcome change. Ghastly means terribly. Now, next exercise of working with language is reword these lines from the story. I had heard a great deal about Miss Beam's school. Means, I had come to know a lot about the school run by Miss Beam. Here, we have reworded the line. The line was, actual line was, I had heard a great deal about Miss Beam's school, and its answer is, I had come to know a lot about the school run by Miss Beam. Number 2, Miss Beam was all that I had expected. I means author, middle-aged, full of authority. Now, how can we write the same line in a different way? Its answer is, Miss Beam was middle-aged, authoritative, as I had thought her to be. So, this is the transformed line. I repeat, Miss Beam was middle-aged, authoritative, as I, means author, had thought her to be. Next, number 3. I went to the window which overlooked a large garden. Now, how can we transform or change this line and how can we write it in a different way? I walked towards a window from which one could see a garden of a large size. I repeat, I walked towards a window from which one could see a garden of a large size. Number 4, we cannot bandage the children's mouths, so they really have to exercise their willpower. Now, how can we transform or write this sentence in a different way and the sentence which can give us the same meaning or the same essence? It is not possible to put bandages on children's mouths, so an exercise of willpower is required on their part. The same meaning, we are getting the same meaning from both of the sentences, but we have transformed the answered sentence. I repeat, it is not possible to put bandages on children's mouths. So, an exercise of willpower is required on their part. C question. Given below is a page from a dictionary. Look at it carefully and number one, find a word which means the same as ghastly. Write down the word and its two meanings. Its answer, the meaning of ghastly is terrible. Its two meanings are causing fear and very bad. Number two, find a word meaning a part of the school year. Answer is a term. Number three, find a word that means examination. Its answer is test. Now, it's time to assign you homework. And your homework is to learn question answers and new words of lesson 5, a different kind of school.